Collaborating with Children's Hospital Boston, we at the Harvard Biorobotics Lab have developed an interactive, patient-specific surgical simulation system for mitral valve repair. The mitral valve is one of the four valves of the human heart and separates the left atrium from the left ventricle. Serving as a passive check valve, it is forced closed during systole, thus enabling the efficient ejection of oxygenated blood from the heart. When valve function is compromised and regurgitation is present, surgical intervention is required, either to repair the native valve tissue or replace the valve with a prosthetic. Valve repair is recommended in all cases as it produces clinically superior results with significant increases in patient survivability. However, valve repair is significantly more challenging as repair plans are highly patient-specific and are often formulated in the operating room. As a result, this procedure is highly underperformed. While top surgeons achieve near 100% repair rates and recommend nationwide repair rates exceeding 90%, the national average falls between 50 and 60%. As seen here, not only is there a large gap between the performance of the average and top surgeon, there's also a strong correlation between surgeon experience and the rate of valve repair. This suggests increased repair rates are feasible with an improved understanding of the mitral valve and improved surgical planning. Because of the complexities associated with valve repair, significant efforts have been undertaken to better understand valve mechanics. However, previous models have been too computationally intensive to permit real-time user interaction, making the planning of procedures difficult. We have thus developed an interactive, patient-specific valve simulation system to address these insufficiencies. One immediate benefit of virtualization is improved visibility. As you can see here, we can view the valve from any angle, facilitating valve analysis and modification. The valve can be simulated to closure in just a few seconds. However, this is a pathological valve. There are regions in which the leaflets don't coapt, leading to regurgitation during the cardiac cycle. Another benefit of virtualization is the ability to highlight the cords experiencing the greatest stress. We select one such cord and decide to lengthen it. The change in valve shape is immediate. Another cord is excised. Nevertheless, regurgitation still persists. We therefore decide to perform an annuloplasty. Highlighted in black is the shape of the unpressurized valve before static loading, our preferred method for inducing valve closure ex vivo. The desired annulus size is selected. After this correction, we see regurgitation is eliminated and valve function is restored.